Back in February, you may remember we brought you the story of State Senator Bob Hooper's struggle to stay in public office while fighting terminal cancer. Well, today, Senator Hooper resigned. Here's 11 News reporter John Sherman.
Long beyond the moment when his doctor and his family told him it might just be best to stay home and rest, Bob Hooper kept going to the Senate in Annapolis to represent his neighbors. But now, finally, it's become too much.
I was always hoping this day wasn't going to come.
On the Senate floor, Bob Hooper's been sitting at Nancy Jacobs' side for years. Their bond is professional and very personal.
You know, every morning how we say the prayer? Hoop and I always grab each other's hand. So it's going to be tough tomorrow.
Back in February,
Good morning. How are you?
We met Bob Hooper at the church he's taught Sunday school at for decades.
Better come on.
We saw the same dedication to young people on the Senate floor, where his trademark high fives will now be strangely absent. Then he told us he'd be ready for today.
The good Lord has work for me to do. He'll keep me here. And when he says, Hooper, you done messed up enough, punch out, come on home, I'm out of here, folks.
He spent much of today in the hospital. He'll be with family from now on.
What you see with Bob is what you get. He is just a wonderful person. I mean, I rank him right up there with my dad as far as admiration. He's a great guy.
Though he'll be gone from the Senate, Bob Hooper's legacy will remain, that when you care deeply enough about what you're doing, limits set by other people or even by your own body don't have to matter that much. In Harford County, John Sherman, WBAL-TV 11 News.